but we felt that we could also get a deeper or a further share of the Alzheimer's and Parkinson's market. And so the diversification is very much about bringing novel algorithms there that differentiate us from some of the competition in these disease areas.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me in the studio today is Bram Goorden. He's the CEO of IXICO. Very nice to have you in the studio with us for a change.
Thanks for having me.
So you're on with your first half results and a very strong showing. Your revenue is up 23%, gross margin improvement. Take us through some of the highlights of the 6 months.
26% revenue increase, actually, compared to H1 24. We've had a great H1, basically because at the one hand, we started to set out this diversification of our portfolio into some new disease areas, which we can talk about, and that has resulted in some good revenue growth as well. Secondly, what we saw was that we were able to expand some of the work that we're doing with existing clients, and that I think speaks to this thought leadership, which we're actually really promoting to make sure that we're partners for our customers and that we're looking at biomarker work with them. So that gave us some extensions to existing work. And then thirdly, and that's very interesting as well, and very much what we were aspiring to do as well, is that we did go into some new verticals, as I want to call it, where we started to work with some diagnostics companies, whereas traditionally we're very much working with pharmaceutical companies.
You've also adopted this innovate, lead, scale strategy. Tell us how that played out over the period.
So innovate, lead, scale is very much about innovation on platform, lead, which is about making some noise about that innovation and being much more present, and then scale, making sure that we actually have the resources and what I would call the feet on the ground, also especially in the US. And so we've started to build that organization. We've started to deliver on platform. So those are things that I am reporting out as well now, because we see those innovation milestones coming on the platform. And we also see the first results now in that pipeline, where indeed we always said that innovation should fuel Alzheimer's, Parkinson's. And so those are the conversations we're having and some of the deals that you've seen coming through as well.
So take us through some of the diversification and how that played out and also helped to boost your revenue.
So diversification, if you look at our platform, we have always equipped it with the latest biomarkers, which obviously are based on imaging, neuroimaging, brain imaging. And they have traditionally very much been appreciated in the areas of rare neurodegenerative diseases, Huntington's disease, where we are absolutely dominant. But we felt that we could also get a deeper or a further share of the Alzheimer's and Parkinson's market. And so the diversification is very much about bringing novel algorithms there that differentiate us from some of the competition in these disease areas.
And also multiple sclerosis, also a focus area.
Multiple sclerosis as well, although we have very deliberately chosen the neurodegenerative space of Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, because we do feel that that's very close also to some of the other work which we have already been doing. So opportunistically, we work on multiple sclerosis, we're serving clients, we're also getting some new deals there in the pipeline, but it is for the moment very much a focus on Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, I would say.
And take us through the new verticals you mentioned just a while ago.
So when I talk verticals, as I just mentioned, we're operating as a CRO, a clinical research organization. We traditionally serve biopharma, biotech. We often do that in collaboration with bigger clinical CROs. But what we saw recently is that we also started to now work with diagnostics companies that are looking at the blood-based biomarkers. And so blood-based biomarkers are believed to complement what imaging can do. Obviously, they need validation. And so at the moment, we're doing validation work, which obviously brings revenue. But my aspiration is also to start to look at partnering with those and actually see how we can bring that on platform.
You ended the period with £5 million in cash, and that follows a fundraise last October. So well positioned going into the second half, also an order book of £13.1 million. How is the second half looking so far?
Very good. We've actually also announced one additional deal in the meantime in Huntington's disease, which obviously is sort of our bread and butter and where we do expect always that deals will be coming in. That cash obviously is not there for the coffers, as I like to say also to the team. It is very much to invest. So we are growing the team, especially in the US. We're still bringing more people on board in operations and commercial as well. And what you expect for H2 is obviously more deals in that diversified space that we talked about a few minutes ago, and then further innovation on platform as well.
I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress with that. Thank you very much for coming through today.
As always, thank you.
Bram Goorden, the CEO of IXICO.